The What Ifs, written by Emily Kilgore and illustrated by Zoe Persko. The What Ifs. Cora was a nervous girl. Always jumpy, always on edge, always wondering if something grim was going to happen. Because of this, the What Ifs loved her. Heavy, lumpy, and grumpy, the What Ifs are everywhere, in bright rooms and dark corners, in busy hallways and hushed libraries, in big cities and small towns. They slink in from unknown places and swiftly attach themselves to people when they least expect it. Then they whisper a question, so quietly, so softly, so gently, that the person usually doesn't know the what ifs are there at all. From the moment the sun first peeked through her window in the morning, to the time she pulled a warm quilt over her head at night, Cora's what ifs followed her every move. What if my dog runs away? What if I forget my homework? What if the sun stops shining? What if my crayon breaks? Many people think about their what ifs for a moment or two, but can briskly brush them off. Cora, though, cannot. It didn't matter if the what ifs question were silly or frightening, likely or impossible. As soon as Cora thought of them, the what ifs grabbed hold of her. One week, Cora had more what ifs than usual. Her piano recital was just days away. Even though she had practiced and perfected her song, the what ifs started creeping in. What if my fingers shake? Cora questioned on Monday. What if I make a mistake? Cora wondered on Tuesday. What if nobody comes? She thought on Wednesday. What if too many people come? She worried on Thursday. On the day of a recital, the weight of the what ifs felt unbearable. Cora stood backstage, anxiously waiting for her turn to perform. The longer she waited, the more what ifs appeared, each one grabbing hold and weighing her down more than the last. What if I trip on stage? What if the bench is too tall? What if the pedals are squeaky? What if I start coughing? What if I play the wrong note? What if nobody claps? Cora, a small voice whispered, are you all right? Oh, great, Cora thought. What if Stella thinks I'm a crybaby? What if she doesn't understand? It's nothing, was all Cora could muster before a tiny sob escaped from her thinly pressed lips. It doesn't sound like nothing, Stella said. Cora took a deep breath and said in a hushed voice, I just have too many what ifs. They make me imagine bad things that could happen. Like what if I mess up? What if I sneeze during my song? Everybody gets what ifs, Cora. Just a minute ago, I asked myself, what if Cora's sad? And how can I help? Listen to Stella, Cora started to wonder, what if she can help me? What if I can trust her? I wish mine were like that. My what ifs are grim. Cora looked down. Do you ever have good what-ifs? Stella asked. I didn't know they were good ones, Cora whispered. Of course they were, Stella said. Like, what if there's chocolate cake after the recital? Or what if I play better than ever? Cora chimed in, peering at the boy pounding his piece on the piano. Cora suddenly felt her what-ifs begin to change. The heavy, lumpy, grumpy what-ifs slowly slunk away, and new ones arrived in their place. Just then, the teacher announced it was Cora's turn. Cora walked out to the piano without tripping. The bench was just the right height. Her hands quivered as they hovered over the keys. But then she sat down and began to play, and the grim what-ifs slowly continued to disappear, until she hit the wrong note. Oh no! What if everyone laughs at me? What if I get booed off stage? Cora wanted to cry. She tried to ignore the people staring, waiting for her next move. Then out of the corner of her eyes, Cora saw Stella. What if I can do this? She asked herself. Cora took a deep breath and started to play again with confidence. Her fingers danced across the keys. When she finished, the room filled with applause. Cora took her bow and smiled at Stella. She couldn't help but wonder, what if I made a new friend today? The end.